You
alright,
mate?
Oh, yes.
How are you doing?
Not bad, not bad. So this is the outside tap you were doing earlier?
This is going to be the outside tap, mate, yeah. This is going to be the outside tap, which I was explaining about inside. Just sort of have a piece of piece. I've got a couple of things, but never mind joking about that. Right, this is what I was telling us about. This is the non-return valve, outside tap. And what it basically does, you've got non-return valve in it there, which stops any water coming back into the system. That's going to be up there, like that. This is called a backplate elbow. That's what your outside tap connects to. And that just goes on there like that with a bit of PTFE. I'll do that in a minute and show you. But yeah, we put that up there. It's got a non-return valve on it. And what that does is, if you've got a hose on out here, attached to it out here on a reel or however you've got your hose, if you've got turn the tap off, you're still going to have water in your hose. If your hose then gets lifted up in the air or moved around, that non-return valve just stops any water going back into your system. That water in that hose could have been sitting in there all winter, frozen up, defrosted again, contaminated water, stagnant water going back into your water system, because effectively that's what that is. It's off your cold mains, which is your potable water, your drinkable water. You don't want any contaminated water going back in there. So yeah, that's what that does. Non-return valve, that's actually water regulation to have one of those on. So yeah, so that's why I didn't put one on the inside. I just put an isolator on the inside because I didn't need it, because it's got that on it there. What I'll also do on here is I'll come out here and I'll put a T on here, 15mm T, and I'll drop that pipe down and I'll put a drain off on that as well. And the reason you put a drain off on that, again, is for your winter months. In the summer months you're absolutely fine, but in the winter what the client can do is turn this tap off from inside, open the drain off up out here, and it will just drain off any water what's in this pipe work out here, so that you ain't got no chance of it freezing up, pipe bursting, anything like that. So yeah, so that's your that's all my fittings. That's my tap, that's my black back plate elbow. I've got my clips up there, screws and a couple of plugs. Yeah, so I'll start doing that. I need to get Joe past my few fittings. Right. Also, what I will tell you, as I've said before, I'm going to sleeve it in 22mm pipe. Joe! In the 15mm fittings in there, can you pass us out a 15mm T and a 15mm coupling? Yeah, one of those, a straight connector. Yay. Well done, Joe. You're learning, aren't you? See? Get your plumbing badge soon, Joe. Right, so what I'm going to do is cut my sleeve here. Let's go right through the wall. Yeah, I didn't drill the hole. But Anton and Brad will make that good. Good at things like that. Right, so there's our sleeve, go through the wall, and again that just stops if anything happens when this wall, frost gets into it, it cracks. That's just going to stop our mains getting damaged. So, what I want to do, now, is get sure we get a pipe. I don't want to come up too high with that, because obviously we're coming out quite high already. So I only want to put my tap up here. What I can do, just cut myself a little pipe off. So I'll just offer this up on here, it's back to the elbow, and that's where it's going to sit. So I want to go in the middle of the brick there, and that just give me a good fixing as well. So that's where I want to be. They ain't singers, are they? It's a good job they're builders, not singers. Okay, so that's what we're going to be on that. Comes out of the wall. Right, I'm going to drill up and get myself a clip. On there. Make sure the drill's on the right side. So I'm using a hand screwdriver for the exercise. What's the matter? What have you done? Yeah. Tell her I'll ring her back.
All good idea, Tony.
Sorry, mate.
All good idea.
Yep.
You should drill a hole in Brad's car.
Should we drill a hole in Brad's car? Do that. And, let's get this outside tap on. What would they? Drill a hole. These cups every time. He goes to drink it. He'll end up tilled over it. Right, I'm just going to cut the apart. As I said, what I'm going to do is put a drain off on it. I'll clip this up. What you might want to do, if it's your first time of doing it, is do it at the level, but I've been doing this quite a long time, so I've got a couple of clips on this. There we go. Well, the way I do it, I've marked the pipe either side there, so now I know if I put my drill hole in the middle, put over some marks, I should. Joe! Oh, Brad passes that one in red plugs. Did you pass that one in red plugs? Lovely. Cheers, mate. Right, so, let's just put this photo skin on here. Using plastic clips on this because all up. He was doing it in gas. I always use Bunsen rings, which are like a brass clip. And they've got screws, two screws on the side of them, a back plate, which screws to the wall, and then a clamp that clamps over the pipe with two screws. And they are much more secure and they're better to use. That's it. I've clipped it up also because now it's going to make it a lot more easier. I need a solder. Well, I'll solder this. Just showing you how to solder. Again, soldering is pretty much the more you do it, the better you get in it. Outside, it's a little bit tricky. New to it, you don't really want to be doing it outside because you can't see the flame, because obviously you're outside pulley reaction when your shoulder runs around your fitting. We'll get your fitting just not warm enough. There we go. Just run your shoulder around. There we go, done. My 15 mil fitting, you only need a couple of mil of solder. So obviously the gap between your actual pipe and your fitting is next to nothing. You haven't got a big gap there at all. 4 mil for 22. In all fairness, when I'm doing fittings under floors or stuff like that, or in cavities, I overcook it. And I'll just put loads of, not loads, but I'll put more than enough solder on there just to make sure you ain't gonna get a leak. Always as well, when you're soldering, have a wet rag. Does two things. It'll cool your pipe down quicker and also clean any flux you've got off the pipe. There we go. It's not bad. You always want to clean your flux off the pipe because, believe it or not, flux will corrode the pipe work half the time and it'll make it pin off. That's how you'll end up with leaks. That's our back weight elbow. What are we doing now? I'm gonna need to change the battery on that drill. Right, where was we? Right, we're just gonna fit the back weight elbow. So I'm gonna sharpen my pencil up, just because the back weight elbow, the holes are quite difficult to get to if you've got really sharpened the pencil anyway. So you wanna get your marks on the wall, just so we know where our plugs in. Builders wear sharpening pencils. Right. That's where I want to be. I know I'm level. And the reason I know I'm level is when I put my clips in, I just went off these brick lines here. So we know that house is built level-ish. I've just come off the brick lines there. And you can see the pipes in the level. So we know we're all going to be level, but if you're quite new to it, use a level. I'm going to take it off. I'm going to be doing drilling this. What I'm going to do is cover the pipe up so I don't get no big dust in there. Five and a half, 6 mil. 6 mil drill bit, 6 mil plugs. Put that on there, hopefully all our holes will mash up. Might need to help me a minute, Sam, when I'm soldering the drain off on. You might need to hold the drain off up for me because I'm putting the drain off in the bottom of that pipe. When I'm heating it up, it might just drop out. What I might need to get to do is just hold it up. It might be a tight fit. Sometimes you can get away with it if it's a tight fit. Sometimes not.
No worries, mate.
Set script wall. Nice and tight, you want to do it nice and tight. So obviously the tap's going to be turned off and on, so you don't want that pulling out the wall. Make sure you've got sufficient fixings in there. Right, let's put the tap on. PTFE. Right, PTFE is a plumber's tape basically. That one's no good, it's sitting in there. Right, there we go. Right, it's a plumber's tape.
basically. This one is for water only. You get this for water and gas. This one here, it'll tell you on it, suitable for potable water. So this is one you use just for your water. The gas one's a little bit thicker. I'm not a lover of it, to be honest with you. I always use Boss White. This is the old trick, I'll show you a bit of Boss White. Right, you're gonna wrap this round here, around your throat, a few times. These always, to be honest, a little bit tricky because you never quite know how much to put on to get your tap sitting in their level. So it's sometimes a little bit of trial and error. I think we need a little bit more there than that. Let's have a look. There we go, start it off. Get it right now. Right, let's look at that. So obviously when you put your tape on, you don't want to go over where your water's going to come in. Let's have a look at that. See if we can really... Yeah, that's nice and tight. Obviously, don't want to over tighten that. If you put too much PTFE on and you have to over tighten, what will happen is you'll just bend your back plate elbow. There you go, it's on there. Perfect. I think I was quite lucky with that, to be honest with you. But yeah, that's that. Right, drying off. Where's my drying off? Joe, can you get me the drying off?
Yeah.
Oh, there it is, mate, lovely. Right, drying off. When you're fitting drying off, what you want to do is take this part out here, because this has got rubber on it, and that obviously stops your water. There, you've got washer on it. Mate, same as a tap washer, but just smaller. So if you look in there, all that does is when you shut that down, that stops the water coming through there and out there. When you open that up, it'll let your water by. And if you leave that in, when you're soldering, it's going to melt that washer, which you don't want, because what will happen is the washer will just get melted in there, you turn your water system on, and it will just pour out. Also, another trick with that, don't over-tighten it. If you over-tighten it, those washers get stuck in there. So when the next man comes along and wants to drain it down, he'll undo that, and he'll get no water out there. So you don't want to over-tighten it as well. Right. Coupling. Flux from the coupling. Don't overkill it. I've got to flush all this system through anyway. There we go, that's on there. Dry off. On there. See that just dropped out?
Yeah.
Right, what will happen if I'm going to solder that? That'll drop out and it'll just make it a pain. So there, that's on there like that. So what you want to do is either get something to prop it up, or if you've got something else with you, get them to hold it. But what might be happening? Just prop it up. I'll just prop it up with something. Doesn't look the best thing in the world to do, but it works. It'll do the job. We're on a site, it's a work environment. Right, again, heat this up. Probably got that one a little bit too fierce. Heat our fitting up just until it's enough ready to solder. And that comes with experience as well, when you know it's ready to go. And there we go. That's it, that's that soldered. Also, this is what I do, and I was taught this way. Some people don't agree with it, but I do, because I always clean the fitting after. Help your solder run with a little bit neater. A little bit of flux, finished. Ready fitting. Neat the job up. And remember, we're going to clean that anyway. So you're going to clean all the flux off what you've just used. And that's that, that's your job done. We'll let that go for a second. Make sure that's off, so when I've got the system on, you don't get water pouring out there. Do that clip up, but sometimes a little bit tight, these clips, there we go. What we shall do as well, we'll put a little bit of insulation on that, lagging on it for you can get all types of different ones to go around your taps and stuff. You might have seen them, Sam, people back gardens.
Yeah.
Just go around the taps and that. We put a little bit of lagging on that and then just get one of them, it's just like colour. It goes over the top of that.
Is there one out
here? I think on the tap, the outside tap come out of here before. But where we've moved the configuration of it around, I'll just move it over a little bit. Alright, let's clean that part up. Take that away now. I didn't want to take that away too early because obviously I'll crack the joint. Get that a little bit of clean up. solder up. And then we're going to do the drain off up now. Quite easy, just wind it in. Remember I said don't overdo it. So just wind it in just enough. Use either a pair of pump pliers or adjustables on this. Whatever you suit you, whatever you've got. You talk at a time. Right, I've just held with biting, so that's enough. You don't want to overdo that because otherwise your washer will get stuck up in here, which you don't want. Because it just causes so much problems to the customer and the next man what comes along. Outside tap the normal turn valve on it. And then we put our drain off at the bottom for winter months so we can turn the isolator off inside. Drain the water straight out there. All this water out of the pipe is going to be gone then, so we ain't got no chance of nothing freezing in there. And it just saves for any problems down the line for the client. Yeah, that's it. That's done. It don't look too bad, does it, Sambo?
No, it looks good, mate.
Yeah, outside job. All ready to go, mate.
Brilliant.
You put a bit of lagging on that, mate. I'll show you how to do that as well. And put a bit of lagging on.